It's rock and roll. Where shall we head to first, James? Your call.
It's quite interesting here, like tree.
Which tree? Cool, well let's go there.
If we can find the top.
That would be very nice. Gosh, I'm going to call every elephant I see from now onwards Joel. They seem to exist mostly in my mind. As we haven't seen elephants in over 2 weeks as well, so that'll be something we're certainly looking out for. And, we're going to show you that they have been around at least. This is in many ways quite beautiful. I mean, look at that. It's sort of like elephant art. Look at all the different colors on that and the different shapes. Those marks there would have been from tusks, the same as that, and the same as that very long one as well. So the elephant literally would have done that as he was breaking the bark off. He would have used his tusk to do that.
You know, those little holes, are they like pierced marks?
No, those are from the tree trunk itself, so that's actually almost how they call it, like the bark connects onto the wood.
Okay.
That's those little pock marks James is talking about, but that's from the tree structure itself. Let's have a quick look at that ring bark.
Looks like it's all the way around. It'll be sad if it's...
Very thick bark as well. Look at this piece. So you have an idea of how thick that bark would have been. Probably 1.5-2 centimeters thick. And obviously this is curled up a bit now as it's dried out since the elephant stripped it off. Now unfortunately, Kadir James mentioned there, this tree will probably this tree will die now. The elephant is actually ring barked. He's taken the bark off all the way around the circumference of the tree. And it's interesting, is that something they typically do? It happens sometimes, but it's not something I do very often. And what's quite sad about it is we've got these two Marula trees that both, I've mentioned them quite a few times before when we've had sightings on here. It's like a big door. It reminds me of, in a smaller way, of that portal that they row through in Lord of the Rings. We've got the mountains either side. This is two beautiful big marula trees, but this one will now slowly over the next few years, over the next few months will die, and over the next few years will lose all its bark and just become this great tree skeleton.
It's very sad, it's such a beautiful tree this one,
eh? Yeah, it's a shame, but it's part of how things go. But yeah, this was probably, like James saying, it's a very spectacular tree. It's probably the biggest marula on this area.
Take a drive around it.
Let's give it a, what shall we call it? A goodbye drive. Wait, let me just line it upright. We'll give you a... salute drive. Yeah. It happens sometimes, but what's interesting as well, I've mentioned it again quite a few times before, when we look at dead trees, it's quite a relative term, a dead tree. Once the tree itself dies, I actually saw some already in there, one of the dead branches, but you find that so many animals start utilizing it as a home. And again, your marula tree is not that hard, it's not the core wood, it's relatively soft compared to your acacias. So it's quite easy for things like barbets and woodpeckers and all kinds of animals to make little holes and cavities in there. So you'll find, come winter time, you'll find all kinds of things living in there, and summer, all kinds of birds nesting in it. So it's almost like just a different part of the tree story. Alrighty.